Poor waste management in Zambia has been a major challenge for many years. Factors contributing to the generation of solid waste are many, but those topping the list in urban areas is the high population growth. But while local authorities are devising ways to deal with this challenge, those with business minds are turning trash into cash. On this week's edition of News In Depth, Pennipher Nyirenda looks at opportunities that poor waste management is creating for the recycling industry. I'm your presenter, Masao Somkwayaya. Stay tuned.
The sight of huge piles of uncollected waste in most Zambian streets and townships is no longer unusual. People go by their daily routines with little or no attention to these piles of garbage. This is despite the refuse, varying in volumes, announcing its presence to those around it. It gets even worse when the wind carries the unmistakable stench of garbage to the recognition of those closest to it. Everyday trash generated at the domestic level falls in the category of what is termed as solid waste. It is this everyday waste that seems to be a very big problem. The effect of poor waste disposal has made the problem even more prominent.
If you look at waste, when you just leave it on the ground, for example landfills, it begins to decompose and all those toxins and gases actually go in the air, and that leads to stuff like air pollution, which is also connected to climate change and global warming and all these issues. And it connects to acid rain as well, so the weather gets affected. Then if you look at things like burying waste, when it rains, the water goes through the waste and then it goes to groundwater. So when people dig boreholes, they're actually drinking contaminated water. So waste disposal is very, it causes a lot of problems, and not forgetting things like rats and vectors and things like that. And it's just, it doesn't look nice. I mean, if you've been to a landfill, you know that when you drive past, it's not a pleasant sight to see.
The non-availability of bins in public places has been cited as a contributing factor in the poor management of solid waste. The residents feel that lack of skip bins in the compounds has led to the indiscriminate dumping of garbage in most areas.
Ngabari tuletere kwa mabini. Akale file bakanso balechita. Chilanganda na bini, chilanganda na bini, chilanganda na bini. Eronga ni pachiberu shwaisa senda flafine baya posa chali ko bwino. Pantu muno mutau ni ulesa ngabalumendo bale no tuchirichiri, bale sundira mabotolo, bale posa fya pa diponse. No manishita ya kolera.
If you've so swefi, the poor management. Somehow we can say bakanso swa sevenzesa. But ngakwa alikuwa tema bini ya fula kwa like ati fima saiko bini, fia fula kwa umwa kuposa. Pakona padopo chiri, padopo chiri, padopo chiri, kutikule bako wino. Dimbi uleli ikali banana wa hawa posa. Uleli akanshi wapu. Mai kula bako wati, no ufuminina kwe no fitu. Afuminina fi no kutari, ala isa na chena mpake isa posa hapa.
On the other hand, inefficiency on the part of the local authorities makes it on the long list of reasons leading to the accumulation of waste. Residents feel that the councils are not doing their part in collecting waste on time and with the required consistency. This is particularly the case in the capital city, Lusaka.
I think the council should do something. They should come in and remove all the garbage. But they are being affected like I'm just across. I'm the manager next time, so specifically, and I've been trying to follow up with the council so that they can just come and to take the action. But nothing has been happening, and my clients again, they're being affected.
An underlying reason contributing to the high presence of solid waste in a number of townships seems to be well known.
Ichilenge fisoso kusangwe finifo fwe bantu, fwe bene fwe katatua kwa tuhusaka. Imiposele ya fisoso tuposa fie apali ponso potu ingafuwae kuposa. Fantu na mayo na ngushitata uwa kwa tuhusaka. Tetule riafye wawera waposa apali ponze. Awe, tutu alomba kwa tibakanso baingira mo. So that vakansu baisa tuwafu wako na ifobene tuwafuana. Chako batinga tuwa mwono mwonesu na nguwale pose chisoso tuwa muikata. Tuwa mtuwa la kofesi ya kanso. So that tuwa musambili shauri ya ukukana pose fisoso, ichipose pose. Noti ukumumaa, lelo kumusambilisha. Nae naya sambilisha kubambi, pantunga tulele kere la fefine, fisoso shuwa kula wafia paliponse. Nga ama nebari country bakwa tashani usaka. Tula kwa kuposu wana, apaliponse, mulesa nga palibini. Kuposu wana tetu posa ka paper punch. Ule itina fena omu ineweka. So na muno mwine, ntutu wapango kula pose fisoso mabini.
The failure by residents to adopt a better attitude towards effective waste management baffles the regulator of environmental matters in Zambia, the Zambia Environmental Management Agency, ZEMA.
Attitude towards the management of waste is something that we have to deal with in this country. I think it's a common practice. You find that somebody will be driving a car and still want to throw something out of the window, or they're on a public bus and using public transport and would still want to throw something out of the window, because the attitude that some members of a community have is that government or the council has, somebody is responsible for cleaning up the environment. But who is government? Even when there are bins, we have seen that where bins are placed, they still have to be perforated, because if you don't perforate it, somebody will steal it. They don't see it as a disposal site, you know. So, and even in cases where disposal facilities have been created, like in the peri-urban areas, in the townships, even when there's a skip, somebody will still choose to dump waste right outside the skip, or just out wherever they think is convenient for them.
The Lusaka City Council agrees that attitude plays a factor in the maintenance of a clean environment. A broader look at the solid waste problem reveals that the increased populations in urban centers are contributing to the increased solid waste volumes.
Because of the changes in our consumer lifestyle, we are generally generating a lot of waste. And I think in addition to that, the population growth. If you look at the population of Lusaka, it's not just Lusaka alone, for instance, as an example, is not the same as before. So the Zambian population generally has grown. The economic activities in key sectors, including urban development, manufacturing or processing in general, have equally been increasing. So all that is generally, growth in the economic activity has resulted in more waste, including solid waste, being generated. So there's pressure now on our disposal facilities to manage the volumes of waste we are generating.
This view is backed by a recent report published by the Zambia Institute for Policy Analysis and Research, highlighting the exponential population growth in urban centers. The Lusaka City Council acknowledges that the high population figures are contributing to the huge generation of solid waste.
The city of Lusaka has been growing infrastructure-wise as well as the population. When you look at the population growth vis-a-vis the generation of waste, you can tie it to that and say that the higher the population, the more you expect waste to be generated. And we've not been spared on that. We have tried to put up some interventions to try and address the matter. But of course, the demand is quite high to ensure that waste is managed.
Eco Zambia, an environmental advocacy organization, also admits that the increased populations are contributing to high waste generation, but ignorance on the part of those producing this waste cannot be overlooked.
People don't really know what they're supposed to do with their waste. So if you go to a home and you ask them, what do you do with your waste? They'll tell you, we bury it in our backyard, or that we burn it. Technically, in the ideal situation, people are supposed to have their waste collected. But then people can't afford that. If you look at the economic status of people, most people can't afford 3 meals a day, and yet they are supposed to pay for their waste to be collected. So people can't really afford to pay for that service.
Just generally speaking, waste is always seen as something that is that doesn't have value, that is disgusting, and that is not really, waste management is not something that people want to be involved with because they see it as degrading, whereas actually it's something that is really important to society. It's something that could lead to an industry that would really benefit Zambia. So we try to raise awareness, to inform people about that. They really need to understand what are the specific consequences for themselves.
Much as the reasons of increased waste can be tossed from one person responsible to another, something still needs to be done in cleaning up the cities. However, the major stakeholder with the responsibility of shouldering the problem admittedly has numerous difficulties.
We realized as a local authority that it's a bit difficult on our part to handle this matter. So what we did was to bring in the private sector to work with us to try and match, the demand for waste collection. The companies that we have engaged are finding on the ground is that there is a high, rate of unwillingness from the waste generators to pay for waste.
With no sight of a sustainable solution to the solid waste problem in relation to immediate collection and onward disposal, others have taken up the initiative to help transform garbage into a revenue-earning resource. From a distant view, these are ordinary handbags, and a closer look confirms their durability. However, the raw material used in the production of these bags is a secret the women who make them were willing to share with us.
This project of making bags using recyclable plastic bags, it works very well in this place, and it has brought a huge change on the face of those people, on the face of the people who are found in this project. So we've put some baskets in different places like schools, working places, and we've gone out there to tell them who we are and what we do with the plastic bags. So when those baskets are full, they do contact us and we do collect them and we spread them among the women.
These are women of Chikumbuso, a center which provides services for widows and vulnerable children. The center is located in Lusaka's Ngombe compound. The women here converge nearly on a daily basis to encourage each other in the production of many artistic crafts which take time to be woven. Waste plastic is the major resource they need.
If we went around Lusaka city telling people how to throw the plastic bags after they do the shopping, I think maybe in a few months' time we would not be seeing plastic bags flying everywhere in our country, because you can look at the pieces that are around here, that we make here, they're very beautiful. But if you look at the plastic which is just flying everywhere, it doesn't look good. So if programs were to put in place to bring the plastic bags to this place, clean ones, I think it will really help. Because thus we are helping, but in a smaller way.
Margaret Temple has been at the center for about 9 years. The bags she has been making have had a positive impact on her life.
Monga kumbari yama plastic, pamene titunga mabagi yama plastic, kuri ife, amene titunga mabagi, chiti tandizira kuoposa kupamba na kutaya ma plastic. Chifukwa muri plastic, tapinduramo zintu zambiri. Kari plastic, amene wataya taya wantu, but kuri ife, irinapindu ikuru maningi. tipunzisiramo vana tiguriramo twakudya na kugurira vana tovara kupyorera muri plastic.
While many who are in business like Margaret desire huge sums of capital to grow their businesses, the women here at Chikumbuso mainly need supply of plastics or funding to help them buy this vital raw material.
These bags are very, very strong. Unless they catch fire, that's when they can be damaged. But the plastic, it takes a long time to decompose. I don't even know if it does decompose, but it can go for many, many years. So even when we crochet them, the way we join the handles, we make sure that where we are joining, we join it properly so that it doesn't come out. So once you crochet something out of plastic, it can stay maybe up to 20 years or so.
Potunga mabagi haya, chamene chimafunika kwene kwene, ni kato ya kuti tigurire maplastic. Chifukwa enango, marisaiko plastic, tima tengako chabe, kurivaja wamine wagurisa mashopraiti, but yamina afu na mune wake mabagi ya buino, tima gura. So ndrama yo gurira maplastic, kambiri imativuta.
Appropriate paper technology, fondly known as APTES, is a center hidden in the premises of Zambia's largest referral hospital, the University Teaching Hospital. A tour inside the APTES premises reveals a hive of activity as the members of staff and volunteers are busy making various aids for children with disabilities. A combination of cardboard boxes and plain paper form the foundation of the standing frames and chairs made at APTES, and the process undertaken justifies the durability.
Out of the recycled paper that we do, we make devices for children with disability, like cerebral palsy. The device that I'm talking about is the special chairs, the standing frames, which helps the child who cannot sit or who cannot stand. So we recycle the paper.
However, APTES has diversified in its work, thereby making toys, trays, tables and stools out of the paper technology. APTES are also making good use of old magazines and newspapers, which are often discarded after use. In addition, wine corks have been transformed into toys for children, which are also a revenue generation product to supplement in the supply of the frames and chairs to children who come from vulnerable homes. Regrettably, the growth of the works done by APTES is hampered by the internal and external challenges they have in accessing their most wanted resource, paper.
The job that we are doing here is quite big and quite challenging. And if people could bring their donations, like papers, pens, anything that they can donate here, their donation will help one child in Polokoso. APTES, the only organization in Zambia which manufacture devices for children with disability.
A few individuals and companies have come to the aid of APTES by personally supplying waste paper to the project. At the time of our visit, Nissan CFAO and Zenaco Bank representatives came to deliver some waste paper, which they collected from their companies.
So what we do basically on a monthly basis, we collect paper from all the offices, and then when it's done, we weigh it and then we bring it here, as well as card boxes, because we do sell parts, so all the card boxes that we use after the parts, we donate them here.
The work by Chikumbuso and APTES are evident of small and medium scale projects involved in recycling at the community level. Nevertheless, recycling has made it on the commercial front, with activities transforming waste material into reusable and durable products undergoing high-tech industrial processes. Here at wonderful group of companies in the industrial area on the western side of Lusaka, waste plastics and sacks are being converted into new products. These waste products undergo a vigorous process that begins with cleaning.
So once the materials are brought to our site, we take them to the recycle plant, wash them, eventually crush them. After crushing them, they pass through an extruder, which is a machine that heats them up to the temperature of about 240 degrees. Some of the end products of the recycling process are sacks, as well as containers, plastic chairs, plastic tables, buckets, washing baskets, sugar bowls, and any other related plastic.
Members of the community are largely behind the success of the project. They help in the collection of these products, which is done at a fee.
At this factory that you have visited, we are able to recycle sacks. So we have involved a lot of people in the community, which on the other hand has created employment for the youths that go to collect the sacks from the dump sites. They also collect sacks from different organizations that disuse them. And once they come here, we recycle them into usable sacks again.
A similar project is being undertaken by Zambian breweries through a project known as Manja Pamozi. The project has empowered members of the local community and has benefits for the manufacturer. The idea of offering incentives to waste collectors is highly recommended by the Lusaka City Council and the Zambia Environmental Management Agency, ZEMA.
What is important from their side also is maybe is to make themselves known that they get this particular material for recycling. Once we put a value to that product, definitely you're not going to see it around. We know that people want money.
It will help the manufacturers put in place incentives for collecting those waste types. I mean, a common example is a Coca-Cola bottle, for instance. You know, you won't find it on the streets because somebody knows that if they take it to Zambia breweries, for instance, as an example, they'll get money out of it. Or the scrap metal. When the iron and steel plants, like a few iron and steel, came onto the market, we saw scrap metal disappear from our streets because people know if I take this scrap, you know, to this company, I'll earn a living from it.
It is for this reason that regulation is being enhanced on the use of plastic.
We have actually made good progress in the sense that there's been very broad stakeholder consultation, and the key ministry, which is Ministry of Justice, that is helping or facilitating this process in line with a mandate, has made quite advanced stages in terms of making this law. However, we have no complete control as a regulator on how long this process takes, but we are positive that this is a law that government wants to put in place in order to regulate that type of waste stream.
It has been established that the viability of the recycling industry in Zambia is affected by failure to separate waste at the point of generation.
People need to know how they can dispose of their waste. They need to know that it can be recycled, that it can be used to make manure and to create value for Zambia. And they need to know the specific way to do it.
We don't have the separation of waste from the generation point. You end up having this waste separated from the landfill. So when you go there, you find there are a lot of waste pickers who are, you know, aggregating waste to try and you know, take it to respective industries or companies that are recycling.
People have to sort out garbage. At the end of the day, we get our raw material, which is plastic, and dump their new the useless material to the dump site. And by so doing, we are working hand in hand with ZEMA to clean the environment.
While the recycling of waste is being promoted, reuse and eventual reduction of waste generation is also being encouraged.
We have recycling, reuse and reduce. These are the three areas that the environmental sector is actually trying to shed more light on so that people can have a deeper understanding of what they can do. Reuse is one thing that is also very easy to do. Even I as an individual and people out there as individuals in their homes could encourage their children to actually get to reuse the different wastes that they produce in a day. You can make recycle art out of it. The different organizations that are making recycle art, children could be encouraged to actually just get a bottle and be able to cut it and use it as a stationery holder. You get to paint it, that a child is also going to get involved in the solution towards solid waste management.
A long-term strategy seen to have potential in dealing with the waste management problem is education. This is why Kachere Art Studio is using art to teach young people on the culture of preserving the environment. Kachere are renowned for constructing the plastic rhino strategically positioned at Long Acres bus stop, which was made out of waste plastic.
In the 60s, when I came here, it was so clean. The park where I'm standing here, it used to be really, really clean. By the time we were building this rhino, the place was really littered with plastic. So we thought, why can't we have an initiative of educating the community, starting with the children actually. So we came together and started collecting and cleaning up this place to build up this rhino. It didn't take one day, since it was education a piece. It took us say 3 months or three months to build it up.
They further recommend a presidential directive on keeping the environment clean.
It would be really, really nice if the president took it upon himself to say, look, I mean, let's take one day in a week to start cleaning our cities. That would be very, very, very good, you know, to just dedicate one day in each week, starting from Chawama, starting from Kalingalinga, starting from, you know, let's implant it in ourselves. I think to be smart.
Similarly, Eco Zambia is working with children in selected compounds in order to promote cleanliness and the ideas around recycling and the reuse of waste.
The big issue is in the compounds, so we go to the compounds. We have a specific focus on early sensitization because we think that it's difficult to change your habits, you know, the way you act towards waste and everything. But if you're a child, then you just accept it as something that you should do. You don't have to change anything because you don't really have our habits yet. So we think children are really important because then in 20 years they're going to be the ones who are going to be producing this waste and disposing of it, and also they can reach out to the wide community by talking to their family and their friends. So we focus on that.
While there are economic benefits of waste, inculcating a mindset of cleanliness is expected to impact future generations positively. Practices that include the burning of waste are being strongly discouraged. This is due to the overriding consequences, thereby the call for good waste disposal, including waste separation. Ultimately, management of solid waste will impact individuals, communities, nations, and the entire globe positively. This will reassure a better place for the current and future generations.
This is where we come to the end of this week's edition of News In Depth, where Pennipher Nyirenda was looking at opportunities that poor solid waste management is creating for the recycling industry. Be sure to join us next week as we look at the development of multi-facility economic zones across the country. I have been your presenter, Masao Som. Kwayaya, please and viewing.